I don't know about you, but I enjoyed making terrariums, or perhaps it's more accurate to say terraria, the plural of the word, as a kid, and I still do today. It's one of the best ways to introduce children to gardening, and it gives them an understanding of nature's life cycles and systems. You see, these terrariums can be stylish additions to any room, either as a large single element or as clusters of several varied shapes. Look for plants that are small-leafed and slow-growing. Also, if the jar has a lid, choose plants that can take high humidity. Fuzzy-leaf plants are probably best avoided because they're known to rot inside the terrarium. Believe me, terrariums are easy to put together. Just add a couple of inches of gravel to the bottom of a jar, then a layer of some aquarium charcoal. You see, this absorbs odors. And add sterilized potting soil, and then just plant them up. Mist the sides of the jar and remove any unwanted soil and water so the soil is moist, but not soggy. When covered and placed in bright, indirect light, you won't need to water the contents of the terrarium again for several months. Talk about a low-maintenance houseplant arrangement. I like to make terrariums and arrange them in groups of three or more. Choosing containers with contemporary shapes and varying heights add interest to the display.